Hello guys, welcome back to our English class. Today I'm going to explain you the activities from your book 4, and in this case we're going to start with the unit 1. It says parties and people, objectives, past perfect. Learn when and how to use past perfect. In this case we have to start with the exercise 1.1, but it says read the following text. And when we finish, we have to complete exercise 1.2. Okay? So it says, my grandparents are going to celebrate their 5th anniversary, and they wanted to know how they met and got married. Grandma had told me that they studied together in high school, but she never finished the story. Now she told me that she was an intelligent girl, and Grandpa was the right fielder of the baseball team. They took some classes together, and she sometimes helped him with his homework. One day, Grandma participated in science fair and won the first place and a prize, a trip to NASA, headquarters in Washington, D.C. The same week, Grandpa's team qualified to play the final match against Benjamin Bankers High School in Washington, D.C. The school committee decided that the baseball team and the science fair winners should travel together. During the trip, Grandpa sat next to Grandma and they talked all the way to Washington, and then found out that they had a lot of in common. They started dating a week later, and they had gone out before, but not alone. They had been boyfriend and girlfriend for some years until Grandpa proposed to her, and then they had planned to get married until they had enough money to pay for everything. And one day in August, they finally said, I do, in front of their family and friends. Okay, now we have to continue with exercise 1.2, that it says, answer the following questions. We have in this case, when did they meet? They met when they were in high school. Number 2, who had always been intelligent in math? Number 3, why did they travel together? 4, until when had they planned to get married? etc. I just gave you the first answer, and you have to complete number 2, 3, and 4 by yourself. Don't forget that it's about the text. Okay, now. On exercise 1.3, I gave you in this case 5 answers. You have to complete the rest 3. Okay, now it says, complete the sentences using the past perfect. We have 1. Grandma had worked in that restaurant until she moved to NY. Number 2. Grandpa had finished college before he got married. Number 3, her parents had met him in a party before. We had talked to our grandma about her wedding before. Uncle Ben had bought grandpa's suit by the time we looked for a dress. My grandparents very good at friends before they got married. Susan offered her house by the time we start looking for a place. And Damien already tell us he could bring the sodas for the party. Okay, so I gave you in this exercise 5 answers, and you have to complete number 6, 7, and 8. Okay, don't forget that it's past perfect. Okay, now on your workbook, we have in this case exercise 1.1, that it says, choose a verb from the box and complete the following text. I want to read the text, and I'm going to give you 3 answers. Okay, you have to complete the rest. It says, last week I was walking on the street with my best friend Laura. We were talking about the day when we met. We both agreed that we had met in the correct moment. when we needed each other the most. She was the new girl in school, and I had been a year before, so I knew perfectly how she felt. That's why we get along very well. Laura used to live in a little town. She had lived all her life there. On her first week in the city, I took her to my favorite places, and she had never a zoo. She used to live near a farm, but nothing like the zoo of this city. She had sushi, but never like one of the Japanese neighborhood. She loved it very much. We also visited some interesting museums. She had to one museum in California, but she told me it was smaller and not very nice. She was very excited every time when we went out. We enjoyed our company very much, and that's why we became best friends ever. Okay, so I told you, I gave you three answers, and you have to complete the next sentences with these verbs. Don't forget that they have to be in past participle. Okay, now on exercise 1.2, it says circle the correct form of the verb. As I told you in the other video, you just need to select the verb that is in past participle. If you want to read the whole idea, it's okay, but the most important part is to choose the verb in past participle. For example, in the first one it says, the storm destroyed the sand castle we had built. Peter had been to Cape Town before 1997. When Sandra went out to play, she had done her homework. My brother ate all the cake that our mom had made. The doctor took off the plaster and he had put on 6 weeks before. The waiter brought a drink that they had ordered. I couldn't remember the poem we had learning the week before. Children collected chestnuts that had from the tree. Pamela had Angie before he went to see her in London, and Josh and Mary had a horse before that day. Okay, and that's all about this exercise. And finally, the last exercise 1.5. Yeah, it says find a mistake on the following sentences on the correct on the lines. Now, in this case, the idea is you have the sentences. We have five sentences, but the sentences are wrong. The idea is you need to identify the error at first and then write the correct sentence on the line. For example, it says, I had been in Acapulco twice. Now, I had been in Acapulco twice. Number two, I had dancing ballet in college. No, I had danced ballet in college. Okay, now what is the mistake in this case? B, it's infinitive form, and in past perfect we have to use the verb in past participle, been. And I had dancing, it's in ing, but it's unnecessary. We have to use the verb dance in past participle, danced, and you have to complete the rest. Okay, we have, for example, Mary had saw the movie last week. I had watched the movie yesterday, and Chanel had designing a dress like that. Okay, in this case, you have to identify the mistake, and then you have to correct them on the lines. And that's all about the exercises from your book. Don't forget to check both videos, the version in Spanish and this version. And that's all, guys. Thanks for watching this video. I hope that you're okay. See you soon. Bye-bye. Espero que les haya gustado el video. Si es así, por favor, suscríbanse. No olviden dejar algún comentario si quieren más videos como este. Compártelo con sus conocidos y denle un buen me gusta al video. Muchas gracias por su atención. Cuídense. Nos vemos pronto con una nueva lección. Bye bye.